How much money do indie developers make? Let's find out. In order to make apps, you can just download Xcode and get started completely for free. I mean, you will have to create an Apple developer account, but that basic version is completely free. And then if you want to actually publish your apps on the App Store, you will need to pay $100 per year, around about that. I mean, of course, it depends on your region and your currency. About $100 per year just to publish your apps to the App Store. So the question is, will you break even? Is it worth it? Also considering the time that you invest. So I actually ran a poll on Twitter, and if you're not following me on Twitter already, I suggest you do so. I post quite a bit of information about iOS development. I run these polls, so if you want to be part of a future one, go ahead and follow on Twitter. It's at FlowWritesCode, the same name as on YouTube. And it actually turns out that out of the 1,000 people who voted, about 1,000 people, two-thirds or 60.4% don't break even monetarily, of course. What that means is that 60% of the people who voted in this poll did not make their $100 back with their apps in the last year. I didn't ask for the first year, I asked for this year, so 2022, last year now. So 60% didn't make their $100 back. So you could say, all right, so in general, you couldn't expect to make your money back, and I would agree with that. But of course, there are outliers, and as you can see, about 15% made between $100 and $1,000, which is nice, just if you just publish your apps and don't really invest too much time into it, if it's just a hobby or a side business. To me, it means that you shouldn't publish your apps just for the money. I think you should do it for fun and don't expect a lot of money if you don't have the time to spend on marketing, optimization, distribution, updates, and so on. If you do have the time, I think it is not that hard to get out of the $100 mark and actually break even. But if you don't have the time and you just want to publish your apps and see what happens, don't expect to break even. Just expect to have fun and learn a ton of stuff along the way. For example, I personally did not make back my $100 in the first year that I had the Apple developer account, but last year I made just shy of $1,000. That is based on a few different apps, but what I have found is that while I have published a ton of apps over the last 2 or 3 years on the Apple App Store, most of them did not produce any significant revenue. They had maybe a few downloads, maybe a few in-app purchases, but not something that I would double down on. But I actually did double down on one app, which is called LaunchBody. You can also find that linked in the video description. It's an app that helps indie developers manage their projects and releases. And I just made it for myself because I always start a project and never finish them. So now I have an app that keeps me accountable. And it turns out that that one did quite well, and most of my revenue from 2022 from my app business actually came from LaunchBody. So I've learned this by creating a ton of apps. Most of them failed, but one of them did not fail, or actually two, but I only doubled down on LaunchBody. Nevertheless, about 15% of the people who voted in my Twitter poll voted for the over $10,000 category. And that's a pretty wide range, as some people in the comments also suggested. It could mean $10,001, which is a nice side hustle, but it's probably not enough to live from it. Or it could mean $1 million. This poll was geared more towards smaller revenue or smaller income from your apps. Of course, I expect there are a bunch of people who earn a lot more than $10,000 per year from their apps. But you also need to remember that this poll is just based on my audience on Twitter, which is mostly smaller indie developers. So in reality, the distribution could be different, but there are also tons more of small indie developers who are not following me on Twitter out there. So I think it's not that different in reality. So my recommendation would be to just publish your apps. Just give it a try. $100 isn't that much money. If it's too much, then don't do it, of course. But if you can afford to spend $100 to have some fun and learn a ton of new stuff along the way, I would really suggest you do so. So for example, you will learn about App Store optimization. You will learn about making nice screenshots, app icons, writing marketing tweets, finding communities on Reddit and other forums to post your app to. You will learn so much, and those are just the things around app development. You will also learn so much about in-app purchases, about terms of service that you will need, about a privacy policy that you will need, about crafting a nice onboarding experience for your app, stuff that you probably are not working on if you just used your apps yourself. So I recommend publishing your apps if you can afford $100, and if you can't, just have fun making them, and maybe one day you will be able to share them with the world. Thanks for watching.